Hello students, in the previous class or in the previous lecture we have discussed about the equilibrium in physical process. Okay, so what is the physical process? Physical process is nothing but which involves the changes in physical properties, not in the chemical properties. Okay, but that was over, and now we are going to see that equilibrium in chemical process. Okay, so it is again very simple. What is the chemical process here again? The chemical process which involves the changes in chemical properties. Okay, or else the chemical composition. Okay, right. You know that what is the equilibrium. Okay, but in this, before going to the here, just we need to see that two types of reactions are possible. Okay, one is the irreversible reaction. Another one is a reversible reaction. Okay, because this equilibrium is possible only in the reversible reactions, not in the irreversible reactions, Okay, so first see what is the irreversible reaction is that, which is a chemical reaction which always proceed to completion in only forward direction, okay. So that means here it is a chemical reaction which always try to complete the reaction, okay. That means it is only go in a only one direction, okay, and it won't come back, right. The best example is that the silver nitrate on reaction with the sodium chloride, it gives the silver chloride and sodium nitrate. Okay, but you see here I am writing this arrow, right? Okay, so here it shows that this reaction is proceeding from left to right, okay, and this cannot come back. Okay, so again the silver chloride, when you mix the silver chloride with the sodium nitrate, it cannot come back. It is only one directional. Okay, and such reactions you can call it as a irreversible reaction. That means very simply it moves in a only one direction, that is a forward reaction. You cannot come back. You cannot come back with the products. Okay, so these reactions never attain equilibrium. Already I said to you, generally the equilibrium attain in the reversible reaction, not in the irreversible reactions. Okay, so then what is the reversible? It is obviously a reactions which do not proceed to completion in forward reaction and also proceed in the backward direction under suitable conditions. Okay, so that means which is not a single directional, like a forward reaction. Here the forward reaction takes place, simultaneously the backward reaction also takes place. Okay, so the best example is that the nitrogen gas on reaction with the 3 moles of hydrogen gas, it gives the 2 moles of ammonia. Okay, and look at the symbol here. So this indicates that it is in the equilibrium, the reaction is in the equilibrium. Okay, so let's see once again. I will tell you how to represent the reversible reactions is that, because so many students are confusing while writing the reversible reactions. Okay, suppose some reactants are converting to the product. You assume that reactants are converting to the product. Okay, if it is irreversible reaction, then you have to show a arrow like this. Okay, so it indicates that it is moving from left to right, so it is a forward reaction only. Okay, so it is a only one directional, so you can say that it is a irreversible. Okay, reaction, right? And now come to that another scenario, that some reactants are converting to the product. Okay, here the forward reaction is taking place and simultaneously the backward reaction also taking place. Okay, so this, instead of this, what it is indicating here, it indicates the forward reaction. It is taking place the forward reaction, and here it indicates that it is also going to the backward reaction. Backward reaction means the products are converting to the reactants, and forward reaction means the reactants are converting to the products. Okay, so instead of these two arrows, generally they will represent like this, half headed arrow, and here is also half headed arrow. Okay, so that means this indicates that some of the reactants are converting to the products, and here it indicates that products are converting to the reactants. Okay, so you have to represent in the equilibrium reactions like this. Okay, right, and in some books it is also, they'll represent like this, but don't follow this one. Okay, so they'll mention like this also. Okay, double headed arrow. Okay, but I won't prefer this, and in, you see, most of the books, so they'll represent like this only. Okay, so be careful while writing the equilibrium reactions. Okay, right. So now come to the, what I said, irreversible reactions. Okay, and generally these reactions, these reversible reactions attains the equilibrium. These reversible reactions attains the equilibrium. Okay, so we are talking about the equilibrium, so that here we always focus on reversible reactions only, because in the reversible reactions only the equilibrium is attaining, so that we always focus only on the reversible reactions, not on the irreversible reactions, because in the irreversible reactions the equilibrium is not attaining, so that we will mostly not focus. Okay, we will only focus on the reversible reactions. Okay, now come to the reversible reactions, right? In the reversible reactions, the rate of forward reaction and a reverse reactions become equal. Okay, you know that generally when a system attains to the equilibrium, generally the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward reaction. You learn many examples in the physical process, right? Okay, the rate of vaporization, okay, liquid to vapor, the rate of vaporization is equal to the rate of condensation. Okay, here is also same thing in a chemical reaction. If it is happening like this, or giving to the products, and it is a equilibrium reaction, then you can say that it is a R1, the rate of forward reaction, and it is a R2, the rate of backward reaction. R1 is nothing but rate of forward reaction, R2 is equal to rate of backward reaction. Okay, and you know that at equilibrium, always the R1 is equal to the R2. The rate of forward reaction always be equal to the rate of backward reactions. Okay, but the concentrations of the reactants and the products remain constant at equilibrium. At equilibrium, the concentrations of the reactants and the products remain constant. Okay, after attaining that equilibrium, now the concentrations at equilibrium, you know that R1 is equal to R2. Okay, so that means you assume that 1 R, suppose you assume that 10 R's at equilibrium, 10 R's are converting to the products. Okay, 10 R's are converting to the products. Okay, similarly, what will happen? The rate, always rate is R1 is equal to R2. So that similarly, 10 products will convert into the 10 reactants. Okay, that means it is a dynamic. Okay, you can see that, you feel that it is a constant. Okay, endukante ikkada manaki constant ga ee concentrations anedi untayi annamata equilibrium daggara. Okay, of course manaku kanipinchakunda konni product reactants ga convert avutuntayi, but the net change is constant. constant. Okay, so that is what he is telling here. Okay, so the concentration of the reactants and the products remain constant. Okay, and they may be equal or may not. Okay, that I will explain, don't worry. So this is the stage of equilibrium and is in dynamic and is in dynamic. Okay, so how it is dynamic and how can we find it is a dynamic, we can see later. Okay, and you know that most of the reactions at the equilibrium are dynamic. Okay, and let us consider a general case of reversible reaction. Okay, so let us see one best example, that A plus B on reaction gives the C plus D, and both are in the equilibrium, both are in the equilibrium. Okay, and you know that A plus B, A and B are the reactants and C and D are the products. Okay, and you know that generally with the time what will happen, the reactants will consume, the reactants can be consumed and the product can be produced. Okay, so how can you represent in the graphical is that if this is the concentration, this is the time, so sorry, this is with the time, so what will be the concentrations, what will be the concentrations. Okay, so what will be the concentration? Initially the reactants concentration will be high. Okay, so that you assume here it is a reactant concentration at zero time, at a zero time. Okay, but what will happen with the time, with the time the reactants will convert into the products, reactants will convert into the product, so that concentration decreases, the concentration decreases. Okay, but what about the products? Initially the product concentration is zero, initially the product concentration is zero. My reaction start avak munduku product concentration untunda? No, that will be zero. But with the time what will happen, the product concentration increases, the product concentration increases. Okay, but it is not linearly, it is not linear. Okay, and after some time what will happen, simultaneously the products can also react to the products can also convert into the reactants and attains the equilibrium, and attains the equilibrium. Okay, so that means at equilibrium now the concentrations of the product, this is the concentration of the product and the concentration of the reactants become constant. Okay, so now you can say that after this point, after this time, you can say it is a suppose zero and you assume it is a 10 minutes and you can say that okay, this reaction attain that equilibrium after 10 minutes, after 10 minutes, because you see that here the concentrations are constant, concentrations are constant with the time, so that you can say that oh, this is the equilibrium stage, this is the equilibrium stage, because at the equilibrium the concentrations of reactants and products are constant with the time. Okay, and one more thing I said to you, at this stage at equilibrium the concentrations of reactants and products may be same or may not be same, but rates are same, but the rates are equal. Okay, that means the rate of forward reaction, that is equal to always to the rate of backward reaction. Okay, so here you see that after attaining that equilibrium what will be the concentration, generally the concentrations of the product is greater than the concentrations of the reactant. Okay, so you assume that here it is a 100 and you see here you assume it is a 95 and here it is a 0 and you can say that it is a 5, it is a 5. Okay, so that you know that obviously here 95 is a greater than the 5, so that you can say at equilibrium it is at equilibrium the concentrations of products is greater than the concentrations of the reactants, but The rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward reaction. Okay, so rates are equal. Definitely, the rates will become equal, but not the concentrations of the reactants and products. It may be equal or it may not be equal. Okay, because in some cases, what will happen? Just I am showing for your understanding. Some cases, what will happen with the time for a reactant conversion to the product? Okay, so initially the reactant concentrations decreases and it attains certain stage, and simultaneously the product concentrations also increases and reaches the same point, and at that point both the concentrations attain the equilibrium. Both the concentrations attain the equilibrium. Okay, so this is nothing but the concentration of the reactant, and this is nothing but the concentration of the product. Okay, right? And here it is a concentration profile with the time. Okay, here it is a zero. You assume that after 10 minutes the concentrations of the reactants and products are constant and are equal and are equal and are equal. Okay, so that you can say that this stage, you can say that it is in the equilibrium. Okay, it is not always like this. Okay, every time product concentration say kundala mari equilibrium daggara reactant concentration takkundalante, not true. It is not like that. Okay, in some cases they may be equal, they may be equal. Okay, in some other cases with the time and the concentration, the reactant concentration, you assume that the reactant concentration, you know that with the time what will happen, it will decrease, and the product concentration will be increases. Okay, this is the product concentration and this is the reactant concentration, and after some time, suppose some t of 5 minutes, they attain the equilibrium. But you know that at equilibrium the concentration must be constant. Okay, there should not be any change in the concentration. Here it is changing, here it is changing. Here you assume that 90 100 unte ikkada em avutundi, some 90 ki vastundi anamata. Okay, so ikkada 0 unte ikkada somewhere 10 ki vastundi, ante ikkada concentration changing, but here it is constant. Okay, so now here you can say that after this point, you can say this, so total system is at the equilibrium, and here the concentration of the reactants greater than the concentration of the products. Concentration of the product. Okay, so don't assume in a single way. In textbook it is like this, so that eppudu kuda product concentration equilibrium attainappudu product concentrations ekkuntayi reactant concentrations takkuntayi ani manam ala assume chesukokoodadu annamata. Okay, so that depends on the reaction. That depends on the reaction. In some cases it is equal, in some cases reactant concentrations ekkundi product concentrations takkundachu, in some cases product concentrations ekkundi reactant concentrations takkundachu at equilibrium. But one thing you should remember is that after attaining the equilibrium, the concentrations of the product and the reactants always be constant. Okay, and at equilibrium again the rate of forward reaction always is equal to the rate of backward reaction in all the cases. Here is also the rate of forward reaction is equal to the rate of backward, and here is also the rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of backward reactions. Okay, yeah, I think you understood, right? So now see some examples for the dynamic equilibrium. Okay, so the best example is that the nitrogen gas on reaction with the 3 moles of hydrogen gas, and it is in equilibrium with the 2 moles of ammonia gas. Okay, and this is nothing but a Haber's process, because Haber scientist, he discovered the synthesis of ammonia in this way. Okay, and the next one is that 2 moles of sulfur dioxide gas on reaction with the 1 mole of oxygen gas gives the 2 moles of sulfur trioxide gas. Again it is in the equilibrium reaction. Okay, next one is that hydrogen gas, 1 mole of hydrogen gas on reaction with the 1 mole of iodine gas gives the 2 moles of hydrogen iodide gas. Okay, again it is also a equilibrium reactions. Okay, right? So again you got a doubt, right? In the physical change, the physical process, we identified that the equilibriums are dynamic. Okay, so how we experimentally concluded is that in the solubility of the solids, especially the solubility of the sugar into the water. Okay, so there we introduced the radioactive sugar. Okay, you just go back to the previous lectures and see that carefully. You can, whatever that I am saying are there in that. Okay, so there we introduced the radioactive sugar to understand the dynamic nature. Okay, similarly here is also we can find out that dynamic nature in the chemical equilibrium, okay, because what we are saying, after some time, first initially the reactants will convert into the products, and after some time slowly the products also react each other to come back to the reactants. Okay, and after that time, after some time, what I am saying, the concentrations are going to be constant. The change in the product concentrations and reactant concentrations are going to be constant. Okay, so mari ala constant ga unnappudu sir mari ela cheptam adi oka dynamic ani cheppesi, right? Okay, just I am writing the reactants first initially convert into the product, but after sometimes again it will come back to the reactants. Okay, and just now I have drawn a graph that the reactant concentrations decreases slowly and reaches the constant value after equilibrium. Similarly, the product concentrations also reaches and attain the constant. Okay, so this is with the time and it is nothing but the concentration, and here it is a reactants concentration and here it is a product concentration. Okay, and you can say that this stage is the equilibrium. Okay, at equilibrium you know that the concentrations of the reactants and products are constant. Constant ante enti, a reactant kuda ikkada reactant, you assume that initial ga nenu 1 mole teeskunnanu ento kontha product ga convert ayindi initially. So equilibrium daggara nenu em cheptunnanu ante, at equilibrium what I am saying, here it is a 0.1 mole is there, here it is a 0.9 moles are there. Okay, endukante here it is the product concentration is more than the reactant concentration. Okay, at equilibrium 0.1 mole and here it is a 0.9 mole. Okay, so ikkada meeku idi change avadu, meeru throughout the time after 10 minutes of time, ikkada nunchi ikkada 10 minutes anukondi, ee 10 minutes lopata 1 mole anedi ila change avutundi. 1 mole lo 0.9 mole emo product vastundi, రిమైనింగ్ 0.1 మోల్ ఏమో రియాక్టెంట్ అలాగే ఉండిపోతుంది అన్నమాట. ఓకే, అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ 10 మినిట్స్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్, వెనెవర్ వెన్ యూ గో ఆఫ్టర్ ద 10 మినిట్స్, ఆ 10 మినిట్స్ తర్వాత మీరు ఎంత వెయిట్ చేసినా కూడా రియాక్టెంట్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ 0.1 మోలే ఉంటుంది, ప్రోడక్ట్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్స్ ఏమో 0.9 మోలే ఉంటుంది. ఓకే, సో దట్ దీస్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్స్ ఆర్ నాట్ గోయింగ్ టు బి చేంజ్. సో మరి ఇక్కడ ఏమవుతుంది, యు ఆర్ లుకింగ్, బై లుకింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కాన్స్టాంట్. సో కాన్స్టాంట్ మీన్స్ 0.1 మోల్ అలానే ఉండిపోతుంది, ఇక్కడేమో 0.9 మోల్ అలానే ఉండిపోతుంది. సో దట్ యూ కెన్ సే, యూ కెన్ ఆల్సో అజ్యూమ్ లైక్ దిట్, అజ్యూమ్ లైక్ దిస్ సార్ ఇది రియాక్షన్ స్టాప్ అయిపోయింది, మేబీ ఇట్ ఈస్ స్టాప్డ్. సో దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ వై దిస్ ఈజ్ నాట్ కన్వర్టింగ్. సో ఇఫ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ స్టాప్డ్, వాట్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం ఇట్ ఈస్? ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏ స్టాటిక్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం, బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ ట్రూ. ఇన్ దిస్ sum of, you assume that in this sum of 0.001 mole, P will be convert into the product, sorry, reactant. So it is not static. What I am saying, it is not static. Okay, ఇది reaction stop అయిందని మనం అనుకోవద్దు. ఇందులో ఇప్పుడు కూడా ఏమవుతుంది, సమ్ ఆర్ రియాక్టెంట్స్ విల్ కన్వర్ట్ ఇన్ టు ద ప్రోడక్ట్ అండ్ సైమల్టేనియస్లీ సమ్ ప్రోడక్ట్స్, సేమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ ద ప్రోడక్ట్స్ విల్ కమ్ బ్యాక్. ఓకే, ఇక్కడ 0.001 మోల్స్ ఆఫ్ ఆర్ కనుక మనకి ప్రోడక్ట్గా కన్వర్ట్ అయితే, సపోజ్ ఇన్ ఏ 1 మినిట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్, వితిన్ ద సేమ్ 1 మినిట్ ఆఫ్ టైమ్ ఏమవుతుంది అంటే 0.001 మోల్ ఆఫ్ ప్రోడక్ట్స్ అనేది మళ్ళీ 0.001 మోల్ ఆఫ్ రియాక్టెన్స్గా కన్వర్ట్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి అన్నమాట. ఓకే, సో దట్ మీన్స్ హియర్ the rate of forward is equal to the rate of backward. That means 0.001 mole per minute of forward reaction is equal to the 0.001 మోల్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్ రియాక్షన్. అంటే సింపుల్ ఏంటి అంటే ఇక్కడ ఏవైతే మాలిక్యూల్స్ రియాక్టెంట్స్ ఒక పర్టికులర్ టైంలో కన్వర్ట్ అవుతాయో సేమ్ టైం లోపల ప్రోడక్ట్స్ కూడా రియాక్టెంట్స్గా కన్వర్ట్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి అన్నమాట. ఓకే, సో దట్ యూ కెన్ సే దట్ దిస్ ఈజ్ నాట్ ఏ స్టాటిక్, హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్, హియర్ ద రియాక్షన్స్ ఈజ్ నాట్ స్టాప్డ్, ఓకే, హియర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ గోయింగ్ ఆన్ బట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కాన్స్టాంట్, ద రేట్ ఆఫ్ ఫార్వర్డ్ రియాక్షన్ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ద రేట్ ఆఫ్ బ్యాక్వర్డ్ రియాక్షన్. ఓకే రైట్, సో దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఐ కన్ హియర్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు కన్వే. బట్ హౌ దే ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ దిస్ డైనమిక్ నేచర్, హౌ దే ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ ద డైనమిక్ నేచర్ ఐ ఓకే, సో వాట్ వీ సెడ్ హియర్ వెన్ ద మాలిక్యూల్స్ ఆర్ మూవింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ రియాక్టెంట్ టు ద ప్రోడక్ట్ అండ్ ప్రోడక్ట్ టు ద రియాక్టెంట్ దట్ ప్రాసెస్ యూ కెన్ సే దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అ డైనమిక్. ఓకే, సో దీస్ డైనమిక్ నేచర్ దే ఐడెంటిఫైడ్, దే ఐడెంటిఫైడ్. ఓకే, సో ఆన్ హౌ ఈస్ దట్ దిస్ డైనమిక్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ద కెమికల్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం ఈజ్ కెన్ బి డెమాన్స్ట్రేటెడ్ ఆర్ ఐడెంటిఫైడ్ ఇన్ ద సింథసిస్ ఆఫ్ ద అమోనియా బై హేబర్స్ ప్రాసెస్. ఓకే, సో హియర్ ఎట్ ఆప్టిమైజ్డ్ టెంపరేచర్, సారీ, ఇన్ ద హేబర్స్ ప్రాసెస్. ఓకే, సో వాట్ డస్ హేబర్ డూ, హేబర్ డన్ ఈస్ దట్ ద హేబర్ ప్రిపేర్డ్ అమోనియా బై ద రియాక్షన్ ఆఫ్ నైట్రోజన్ విత్ ద హైడ్రోజన్ అండ్ అబ్జర్వ్డ్ ఇన్ అ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం స్టేట్ ఆఫ్టర్ సర్టెన్ టైమ్. ఓకే, సో ఫస్ట్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ ఎ రియాక్షన్ ద నైట్రోజన్ ఆన్ రియాక్షన్ విత్ ద హైడ్రోజన్ హీ ఫౌండ్ దట్ ఆఫ్టర్ సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అటైన్డ్ ఎన్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం అండ్ హీ కంక్లూడెడ్ దట్ ఇనిషియలీ ద హైడ్రోజన్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ డిక్రీజ్ అండ్ నైట్రోజన్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఇస్ ఆల్సో డిక్రీజ్ అండ్ సైమల్టేనియస్లీ ప్రోడక్ట్ కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ అమోనియా ఇంక్రీజ్ బట్ ఆఫ్టర్ సమ్ టైమ్ ఆల్ ద కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్స్ అటైన్డ్ ఆర్ ఇన్ ద కాన్స్టాంట్. ఓకే, సో ఈ సెట్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద ఈక్విలిబ్రియం స్టేట్. ఓకే, అండ్ నౌ ఇన్ ఆర్డర్ టు అండర్స్టాండ్ ద డైనమిక్ నేచర్ ఆఫ్ ద రియాక్షన్ వాట్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ ఈస్ దట్ వెరీ సింపుల్, జస్ట్ ఐఎమ్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయినింగ్ ఇన్ అనదర్ పేపర్. యూ అజ్యూమ్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ వన్ వెజల్ అండ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వన్ దిస్ ఈస్ ఎన్ అనదర్ వెజల్ క్లోజ్డ్ వెజల్. సో ఇన్ దిస్ వెజల్ ఫస్ట్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ ద రియాక్షన్ దట్ ఈస్ ద నైట్రోజన్ గ్యాస్ ఆన్ రియాక్షన్ విత్ ద 3 moles ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్ గ్యాస్ ఆన్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం గివ్స్ ద 2 moles ఆఫ్ అమోనియా గ్యాస్. ఓకే, సో దిస్ ద వెజల్ వన్. ఓకే, సో ఇన్ దిస్ వెజల్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ దిస్ ఫస్ట్ రియాక్షన్. ఓకే, అండ్ సి ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ టు ఐడెంటిఫై ద డైనమిక్ నేచర్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ ద సేమ్ రియాక్షన్ ఇన్ అనదర్ వెజల్. ఓకే, బట్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద హైడ్రోజన్ హియర్ హీ హ్యాస్ టేకింగ్ ద డ్యూటీరియం. ఓకే, యు నో దట్ D2 ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎన్ ఐసోటోప్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్. ఓకే, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎ ఐసోటోప్ ఆఫ్ హైడ్రోజన్. ఓకే, సో ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద హైడ్రోజన్ హీ హ్యాస్ టేకింగ్ ద 3 moles ఆఫ్ డ్యూటీరియం గ్యాస్ అండ్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ దట్ రియాక్షన్ అండ్ ఫౌండ్ దట్ 2 moles ఆఫ్ ND3 gas. ఓకే, సేమ్ ఇన్స్టెడ్ ఆఫ్ ద హైడ్రోజన్ హీ హ్యాస్ టేకింగ్ ద డ్యూటీరియం ద అనదర్ ఐసోటోప్. ఓకే, సో ఈవెన్ విత్ దట్ ఆల్సో హీ ఫౌండ్ దట్ సేమ్ కన్వర్షన్ సేమ్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియమ్స్. ఓకే, సో ఇట్ ఈస్ ఇన్ ద అనదర్ వెసల్ టూ. ఓకే, సో ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ వాట్ హీ హ్యాస్ డన్ ఈస్ దట్ హీ మిక్స్డ్ బోత్ ద వెసల్ వన్ అండ్ వెసల్ టూ. దట్ మీన్స్ ద ఇన్ ద రియాక్షన్ వన్ యూ అజ్యూమ్ దట్ అండ్ ద రియాక్షన్ టూ. ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ హీ మిక్స్డ్ బోత్. ఓకే, సో ఆఫ్టర్ దీస్ వెన్ యూ మిక్స్, ఓకే, వైల్ మిక్సింగ్ యూ కెన్ హీ సెడ్ దట్ ద ఫస్ట్ వెసల్ ఈజ్ అండర్ ఈక్విలిబ్రియం. So first vessel is at the equilibrium and second vessel is also at the equilibrium. Okay, so equilibrium ante enti ee particular equilibrium daggara nitrogen concentration, hydrogen concentration, ammonia concentration constant ga untai, change avu avuna kada, and ikkada equilibrium kada attain ayindi, so ikkada kuda nitrogen, deuterium and nd3 concentrations anetvi constant ga untai. Okay, so constant ga ante enti, you assume constant means maybe sir the reaction is stopped, reaction is stopped. Okay, so mari reaction stop aithe ee concentrations aithe nitrogen, hydrogen, ammonia untaya avu eppadiki alane undipothayi avuna kada, right? So after mixing here what he observed in this nitrogen plus hydrogen plus Again, what is there? Nitrogen plus deuterium, and all are in equilibrium. And along with that, what is there? Some products, N ammonia and Nd3. Okay. So, అన్నిటిని మిక్స్ చేస్తే ఏమొస్తాయి మనకి? నైట్రోజన్, హైడ్రోజన్, అమోనియా, నైట్రోజన్, డ్యూటీరియం అండ్ Nd3. ఇవే ఉండాలి కదా ఇందులో, రైట్? ఓకే, అదర్ దాన్ దట్ ఈస్ దేర్ ఎనీథింగ్ ఎల్స్? నో. ఓకే, బట్ వాట్ హీ ఫౌండ్ ఈస్ దట్ ఆఫ్టర్ సమ్ టైమ్ వాట్ హీ అబ్జర్వ్డ్ ఇన్ దిస్ వెసల్ ఈస్ దట్ ఎలాంగ్ విత్ దీస్ he also observed some NH2D and NHD2 and HD. Okay, so like this, these kind of products also he observed. Okay, so with this what he concluded is that if suppose the reaction is stopped, if the suppose at equilibrium, the suppose the reaction is stopped, okay, so then there is no formation of these kind of molecules. Okay, but what is happening here? The reactions are not stopped. Okay, after that what is happening? Some of the deuterium is reacting with the ammonia, and it is okay, some of the ammonia is coming back and again reacting nitrogen with the deuterium, and it is giving some type of NHTDU and NHD2 and HD molecule. Okay, even the hydrogen and deuterium also mixing together. Okay, so with this what he confirmed is that these reactions are not stopped. Okay, these are in a dynamic, these are not in the static, these are in the dynamic motions. Okay, so with this he confirmed that reaction, whatever that reaction, ammonia synthesis reaction, is not static, it is not static at equilibrium. Okay, but it is dynamic. Okay, of course, just you understand this, the reaction is dynamic, for that only he has done lot of experiments. Okay, right, you have to understand this. Only the thing is that to convey that the reaction is not in the static at that equilibrium, it is in the dynamic motions. Okay, so here again I am reading, in order to understand the dynamic nature of the reaction, synthesis of ammonia is carried out with exactly the same starting conditions but using the deuterium in place of the hydrogen, and he found that same reaction Nd3, and after attaining the equilibrium, these two mixtures, equation 1, that this mixture and this mixture, they have combined, he is combined. Okay, are mixed together and left to for a while. Okay, so కొద్దిసేపు అలా వదిలిపెట్టాడు అనమాట. ఓకే, లేటర్ వెన్ దిస్ మిక్చర్ ఈజ్ అనలైజ్డ్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫౌండ్ దట్ ద కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ అమోనియా ఈజ్ సేమ్ యాజ్ బిఫోర్. కాన్సన్ట్రేషన్ ఆఫ్ అమోనియా అలానే ఉంది, బట్ వెన్ దిస్ మిక్చర్ ఈజ్ అనలైజ్డ్ బై ఎ మాస్ స్పెక్ట్రోమీటర్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ఫౌండ్ దట్ అమోనియా అండ్ ఆల్ డ్యూటీరియం కంటైనింగ్ ఫార్మ్స్ ఆఫ్ అమోనియా అండ్ డైహైడ్రోజన్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ డ్యూటీరేటెడ్ ఫార్మ్స్ ఆర్ అబ్జర్వ్డ్. ఓకే, అమోనియా NH2D, NHD2 Nd3 and Hd and D2. Okay, so with this what he confirmed is that he concluded that the scrambling of hydrogen and deuterium atoms, scrambling means okadaani nunchi inkokati shift avutundi. Okay, earlier ga ammonia okate undedi, kan ammonia lo nunchi malli back reaction ay malli deuterium tho reaction ayindi anamata. Okay, that is nothing but the scrambling. Okay, so atoms in the molecules must result from a continuation of the forward and reverse reactions in the mixture. So with this he concluded that it is not a static, it is in the dynamic, and there it is, the forward reaction is happening and the backward reaction is happening, but with the same rates. Okay, so these results clearly indicate that the chemical reactions reaches a state of dynamic equilibrium in which the rates of forward and backward reactions are equal and there is no net change in the compositions. Okay, the net change is nothing. Okay, all right. Okay, so there is a one more example also there, but the video is going to be lengthy, and this we can discuss in the next lecture. Okay, next lecture, and along with this example, the one more important topic, that is the law of chemical equilibrium that we are going to be see in the next lecture. Okay.